Hello, hello, it's ElectraSnow, and I'm going to be showing you how to cut the lace correctly on a lace front wig. So when you first get your lace front wig, you want to make sure that you check it for any problems or tears in the lace, because that lace doesn't actually finish completely where those hairs start. It finishes back in the wig cap. It has three combs at the front, it has two at the side and one in the centre. It also has the adjustable drawstrings at the back. Now, I've got quite a big head, so I always put these on the outer side ones, but you want to adjust those to be your desired length for the size of head that you have. Now, with these little drawstrings, I always stitch them to the desired length that I want the size of the cap, and I do that because I always go in and style my lace front wigs. So I like them to be kept there because I don't want to be having to take my wig and putting it upside down like this and having to reattach those every time, because I'm going to end up damaging the style that I've put my wig in. So I like to just stitch them so that they're in place. I only put like a little tacking stitch over the little bit of plastic there is there and onto the little band there. I only do that there. I don't stitch onto this bit of elastic because I want it to be able to have the full stretch. But I just do that. That's a personal preference for me. Now, this is actually a full lace wig. It has the tracks stitched onto lace inside the wig itself, but it is full lace even though the back of the wig isn't ventilated. And by ventilated, that is what the lace at the front is done. When these hairs are put in individually, that's called ventilating the wig. So this is a full lace wig, but the back isn't ventilated into the lace itself. It's been stitched in wefts. Now, I have a massive forehead, so I don't have to worry too much about putting a wig cap on for testing this. But you would want to wear a wig cap to keep everything out of place when you are wearing this styled. Now, the first thing you want to do is put it on. Oh man. You want to put it on and you want to adjust your lace down to the size of forehead you want and make sure that these little ear tabs go all the way from ear to ear. Now, this wig is very large, so it does fit my massive man forehead. I have a little bit more leeway with making this blend in better. Some people have a hairline which comes a lot further down onto their temples, and some drag queens would cover that the same as they would with their eyebrows. They'd just take a bit of glue stick, they'd cover over their hairline, foundation and powder it as they would with their covering their eyebrows, and they would be able to change the shape of their forehead by covering up that hair growth. Some wigs won't always fit from here to here, but that's a sign of you've got a good wig when they do. Now, everybody's face shape and head is different, but you want to make sure that it goes and covers up your sideburns and it fills down to where your ear starts at the back of your head, just there. And these little bits of lace are kind of your guidance when you're first trying this wig on and styling it, to make sure that this actually does go from ear to ear. Now, this wig does, and I can see on this wig I have a tiny little flaw there in the lace, but when we get to cutting that in a minute, that flaw is going to be cut out. Normally your wigs wouldn't have that kind of ripple there. It would just be a smooth transition from skin into lace. Now, I'm just going to put a side part in this wig here so I can see how far. Now, here the lace does go back about an inch before a track starts, which I don't really like my wigs like that. I like a little bit more of lace around here, but if you was to wear this in a middle part in, the lace does go back a good 2.5 inches. But that's just personal preference of how you like to style your wigs. I never really like a center parting. So I'm gonna just put a rough parting in. Now, this wig has been ventilated backwards from the lace, so you're gonna get that stand up, that you'll get like a quiff in the front, which will be a lot easier for styling with volume later on when I get to styling this wig. Now, the curls don't seem to really knot, but they do get a bit fly away on this wig. Now, this is literally just out the bag. There's been nothing done to it, but I'm quite happy with this. I like it. Now I'm gonna get to cutting the lace. The first thing I'm gonna cut is this ear tab. Now, these are the ones that go down the side of the face, and a lot of people cut these wrong. They cut them kind of in a diagonal direction like that, or they cut them in a diagonal direction that way. All that will result in is you not having enough lace to stick down at the side of your face if you cut it in this direction, or if you cut it in that direction, you'll just end up with too much bulk around your ear, so the front of the lace won't sit down snugly with your face. So the first thing that you want to do before you apply it to a head, this is the first part of lace that you want to cut. You want to cut this in a straight line. So where the clip is your guidance. You don't want to cut up, you don't want to cut any directional, you just literally want to take it and cut straight into the wig itself. Now these are old scissors. You want to make sure that they're still sharp, but you don't want to be using the scissors that you use to cut hair with, because you will blunt them a lot faster when you're cutting fabric and anything that isn't hair itself. Now it's a straight line following the hairline, so it may look slightly diagonal here, but that follows where the hairline stops and it is a straight line across to the wig. Here, this corner here, we're going to start to cut off now when we cut up the lace here. Now I did put this wig on a head block, but it's going to be a lot easier for me to film showing you how to cut it when it's open like this on a table. Now the lace, it all depends on what it is you're going to be wearing this wig for. If you're going to be wearing this wig on stage and people aren't really going to be seeing you up close, you can leave a slightly larger percentage of lace here at the front, because that will make your wig last longer. You won't get any problems that way because you'll have a little bit more lace to play with. But if you're going to be wearing this for kind of cosplay where people are going to be seeing up close and kind of inspecting you on the way your hair looks, I personally don't like to cut it completely up to the hairline itself. Some people do, but my preference is to leave about a centimeter's width or a finger's width around the lace itself. And I always leave a slight bit more here at the edges, because these are the two parts where you're gonna be applying glue to get it taut onto the face. So I like to just have a little bit more of lace there so that I have a little bit more of gluing space. Here is the side tab. Now, as I say, I like to leave a little bit more there. So I'm gonna be cutting around into the hairline, and I don't wanna leave a jagged corner, but I'm gonna be cutting into the hairline and arcing my scissors round ever so slightly. You don't want these cuts to be straight lines like that. And when you're going in and you're coming up to the hairline up here, I'll show you in a minute what I'm gonna do, because there is a little technique you do there to stop this from looking so fake. Now, if this is your first time cutting a lace front, I would tell you to do this bit by bit. Don't go straight in and cut it all the way around and then, oh shit, I've cut too much off. But just cut a little bit less than you think you need, and then you can always go back in and trim a little bit more. Now this here is where we're coming up to that little flaw that I have in the lace. And I'm just gonna arc round. This is beginning to get to the point where I need to tell you that little trick. Now here you can see is where the hairline is beginning to change, where it gets to the top of the head. Now you don't wanna be going in with the scissors and cut like that, and then change the direction and cut like that, because you'll end up with a little kind of like corner, and that is a stress point for the lace, which will end up kind of getting a rip eventually in the lace itself, because you've made that tiny little 90 degree angle, which will just result in a tension point which will rip the lace up to the hair and then result in you losing a patch of hair at the front or ruining the wig entirely. So when you get up to this point here, you don't want to be cutting straight, you want to curve your scissors round with the hairline. Now here I've not taken off enough yet, but that will just justify me in the area where I want to be cutting so that I don't make that mistake of cutting too much off. So I'm just going to go all the way around the wig now, and I'm going to take off this excess lace. Now I'm almost to the other side. Now this is where I want to make sure that I leave just a little bit extra there where I stick my glue down with. So I'm going to come in from the bottom and join up with my line that I cut from the other side. That's the main bulk of the lace cut off, and as you can see, it's not necessarily that much on this wig. Some wigs will come with a hell of a lot more lace than this, but that is the amount I've taken off of this. Now this isn't completely done yet. There is a little bit more stuff that I like to do to this, just so that it looks a lot more natural. That area there where I leave my glue tab, at the moment it's this tiny little corner, I think you can just about see that on camera. I like to just go in with my scissors, and I'm going to try and do this so I can show you. I like to just curve them around so that I get a curve there instead of a pointed edge. because that is the thing with the lace front. Any harsh edges, people are going to notice a lot more than they would curved ones. Curved ones kind of blend in with the skin. Now this is going to be covered up near my ears anyway and have hair go over it, but I just like to do that just in case you see any visible lace around the parts of the temples just there. Up here at the hairline, I will just customize this a little bit further to me. There's a little tiny edge which I just want to curve off. If you get those little jaggedy edges, just go into the lace a little bit more and curve the scissors around just to kind of cut with this part of the blade here. Don't use the tips, cut with that part of the blade so you can just curve that edge off, and you can kind of just grind that edge off with that part of the blade there instead of cutting too much lace off from the wig. This lace, I won't say is forgiving, but you can get away with a few little minor problems with it. And if you're, as I say, you're wearing this on stage and people aren't going to be right up close to you, it doesn't really matter too drastically if they can see it from afar, because you're going to have heavy makeup on and stuff like that anyway. But that there is the lace cut down. As you can see, I cut it ever so slightly closer to the hairline at the top, but I leave a percentage of lace there at the side, about a finger's width when it gets down to the tabs. Now I've gone ahead and popped the wig back on after I've cut the lace, and I've put it into the side parting that I like. I just went ahead and cut a little bit more of the lace off here, purely because I know that I'm going to be wearing this wig in this style and keeping the fringe going in that direction. Now this is literally just shake and go, and I've done nothing else to this at the moment. I will be going in and styling here a little bit more so I have a little bit more volume to it. And I might reset some of the curls just so I can get more of a custom fit to how I like the style to look. But this is how you cut the lace off. So yeah guys, I hope you enjoyed that video on how to cut lace on a lace front wig. All of my social media links are down in the description below, so come and follow me along over there. Please give the video a thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't already. And until next time, bye bye.